Recipe for success. Recipe for success, Barbara Cusack.
Good evening and welcome to Cookie's Kitchen. Tonight, I'll be serving up the recipe for success. With a show of hands, how many cooks do we have here tonight? Okay, let's be honest. Can there be too many cooks in the kitchen?
Yes.
In my house, the answer is yes. But I can guarantee you, I never used any sharp objects to get my point across. It is a little known fact that I personally have been to Hell's Kitchen. And let me tell you, it is hot, hot, hot. But from that experience, I learned two key ingredients for success that the hot one does not want you to know. The first one is, you need to feel good all the time. You may think to yourself, that's impossible. But really, it's not. I like to wake up from the song from Oklahoma. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I have a wonderful feeling. Everything's going my way. If you do that for 21 days and beyond, you will see a transformation begin from the inside out. Think about it. If you have too many negative thoughts cooking up in your brain, that is a recipe for disaster. You need to transmit out into the atmosphere, I feel good about myself. Therefore, stand up straight and tall, hold your head up high, so when you walk in that room, you just lose confidence. Because the way you carry yourself is the way you feel about yourself. I'd like to share a story with you about a father and son. At one point, the little boy got ahead of his father, and he slipped and slid 30 or so down yard the mountainside. And he was holding onto a tree branch, and he screamed, "Help me, help me!" A voice came back, "Help me!" The little boy looked confused and yelled, "Who are you?" A voice came back, "Who are you?" The little boy got aggravated and yelled, "You're a fool!" The voice came back, "You're a fool! You're a coward!" The voice boomed back, "You're a coward!" At this time, the father got to the son, and the little boy said, "Daddy, who is that over there?" The father just laughed and said, "Son, that's an echo. But really, it's called life." He said, "Let me show you something, son." So the father hollered out, "You're a winner! You're a winner! You're talented! You're talented! You've got what it takes!" And the voice rang back, "You've got what it takes!" The father said, "Son, that's how life is. Whatever you send out always comes back to you." Too many people today go around with this big bowl of negative energy. They feel bad on the inside. They have a recording that's constantly telling them, "I am too clumsy. I'm too old to learn a new skill. I will never measure up to my parents' expectations. It's too hard to eat healthy, and who has the time to exercise?" These folks are transmitting out in the atmosphere self-doubt, low self-esteem, and procrastination. The second key ingredient is putting people first. People love to be served and have somebody listen to them. Like my mother always told me, that is why God gave us two ears and one mouth. So, the next time you're at an office party, networking function, Toastmasters, or even at church, go out of your way to make somebody feel important and appreciated. My heart goes out to the alcoholic or an outcast because I can relate. Back in 1996, my husband, who was an alcoholic, unknowingly infected me with HIV. He passed away of complications of HIV, and I became a young widow at 32. Immediately, I got in self-preservation mode. The recording in my head was, "What about me? What about me?" The idea of putting anybody else's needs or interests before my own was way off the radar. I had a lot of guilt, shame, anxiety, and fear. And for 8 long years, I was a hot mess, and I was in Hell's Kitchen. I got tired of being there. So I asked God to forgive me. And he showed me that he loved me. Then he began to teach me how to put others' needs and interests before my own. When you shift that negative energy and you get out of the pity party and you put others' needs and interests before yourself, you will be liberated. Think about this. Life is meant to be lived fully and intentionally, and there is no pit too deep, and God's arm is not too short where he can eek you out of Hell's Kitchen. I'd like to share this quote with you from Ronald Reagan. Putting people first has always been America's secret weapon. It is the way we kept the spirit alive, a spirit that drives us to dream, to dare, to take risks for the greater good. So, let us recap this recipe. To have success, feel good all the time, wake up with a song and watch the transformation begin. Then put people first, listen and serve. So, let's start cooking.